Hi, I'm Jarrod Le Blanc, and you're watching Maine Freedom Watchdogs. We address the issues that affect your freedom here in Maine. Thanks to the Fourth Amendment, Americans have historically been able to feel secure in their person. We've been free from unreasonable search and seizure, and generally we've had the right to privacy. In the immediate aftermath of the 9/11 attack, Congress passed the Patriot Act, which was the most unconstitutional piece of legislation since the Alien and Sedition Acts. The Patriot Act has obliterated our Fourth Amendment right to privacy. Now the South Portland Police Department is using traffic surveillance cameras that can scan and store up to 3,000 license plates an hour. It stores your information even if you have done nothing wrong, and once you're in their database, the South Portland Police can use GPS to track you wherever you go all day long. I attended a public hearing in Augusta on a bill, LD-1561, an act to regulate the use of traffic surveillance cameras. Senator Dennis Damon sponsored the bill, and it would ban the use of these surveillance cameras in South Portland and the entire state of Maine.
Once all of the testimony has been received on this particular day, we will close the public hearing, and a work session will be scheduled on the bill, again a public session, but at that point the committee will get together and review the testimony and make its decision on its report, whether this should be a bill that ought to pass or ought not to pass.
Last summer, the South Portland Police Department received funds through a Justice Assistance Grant that I used to improve our department's technology. This included the purchase of an automated license plate reader, as you know, is ALPR. I urge you to think about this technology as an additional tool we use to do our job. It's collected and utilized to arrest wanted people, identify criminal suspects, locate missing persons, and recover stolen property.
The police do not need this surveillance system, this spy camera, nor should they have it. Let me offer two hypothetical situations. First, let's say there's a police chief in a big Maine city who hates guns, who prides himself on not carrying a gun, who takes a statewide leadership role to restrict our right to own, possess, and use guns, and who snubs his nose at the law by refusing to issue concealed carry permits. This hypothetical chief sends a patrol car out to the local fish and game club every time club members and others are shooting on the firing range. He sends a car and camera to every gun show, cruise the parking lots, and find out who's buying and selling firearms. Doesn't take any imagination to conjure up ways this anti-gun chief of police might misuse the information to harass and intimidate law-abiding gun owners.
You might also get access to that person's social security number. You might get access to that person's medical history, depending on what databases you can access. You might get access to that person's financial data, marital status, political affiliation, tax status, and literally any other manner of personal identification that is currently housed in some data file.
Senator Damon, Representative Mazurek, and committee members, I'm Lynn Williams. I am a civil rights attorney from Bar Harbor, Senator Damon's district. I've also done my share of criminal defense over the years. We have a U.S. Constitution and a state constitution, both of which guarantee us, under those constitutions, the right to be free from illegal searches and, by extension, a right to privacy. It is my opinion as a civil rights attorney that this usage of these ALPRs and the compiling of the information is a violation of both of those constitutions.
I've done nothing wrong. There is no reason for my whereabouts to be tracked and retained for any period of time.
I do not want to have this in Maine. I don't care if we're the first state to say no to this technology. We should be.
Every picture that the camera takes goes back to a database that's kept at the South Portland Police Department. It generates a database of every single license plate that the car has passed. Not just the ones that were matches, not just the ones of criminal wrongdoers, every single license plate, over 3,000 license plates per hour. And the database itself has the license plate number, the picture, a date, time, and location stamp. What this creates is a virtual map of ordinary citizens' movements around the community.
Well, I will say I have worked closely with the Maine Civil Liberties Union on a number of issues and was very opposed to the Real ID, and I think that this is along the same lines of Maine citizens being concerned about whether or not they're being tracked or and so I am supportive of Dennis's bill.
It's one thing to put people, inmates, prisoners under surveillance. It's quite another to keep people under surveillance that have done absolutely nothing wrong and yet could be on a database that can be bought, sold, or hacked by anyone. Anyone would have access to that information. It just isn't the privacy that our Constitution provided for us.
You will hear from supporters of this technology that their interest is very limited. But we know from experience that inevitably mission creep expands use of powerful technologies from law enforcement to intelligence gathering to total information awareness.
I'm not surprised so many citizens showed up for this hearing. Our primary instinct is survival. It is that survival instinct that kicks in when your freedom is threatened. It is basic survival instincts to push back against a police state that will eventually turn all of the common people into obedient slaves. We really need to put this in context. Ben Franklin was correct. Trading freedom for security is folly, and we have let cowardly leaders talk us into doing just that for the past 10 years. We can never be 100% safe. Life has certain inherent dangers, and freedom requires us to accept some risk. If we sacrifice all of our freedom for the illusion of security, we're going to end up with tyranny. Unfortunately, many aspects of tyranny have arrived in America, and the number of tyrannical aspects of American society is growing. If it came on all at once, people would be more likely to stand up to the tyranny, but it doesn't happen that way. It's happening incrementally.